like before I was even talking, all things, a microphone in my hand. I was singing in church like as soon as they would let me. When I had sleepovers as like a little girl, it's like I dressed everyone, we had a fashion show, and we were a band. And like, you're the drummer, you're the guitar player, I'm the singer, like we're doing this. I have two older brothers, I'm the youngest. My older brother Micah actually taught me how to play guitar. McLean started playing first, so we're kind of a little bit of a low-key family band.
The cross side of the family, of which I'm a part, is where Mackenzie gets her music ability.
She never got in trouble or anything?
Nowhere near as much as Micah.
Yeah, everybody else calls her Mac, I call her Kenzie, I guess. She would start poking me and I'd say, Mom, if she doesn't quit poking me, I'm gonna poke her back. And I would poke her back, and then she would start crying and I would get in trouble.
Mackenzie was a toddler when we knew her.
And she was just a little tiny girl with a little ponytail.
She got to sing in church and she was standing up there with her dad and she just sang her little heart out and she was actually singing to her dad. And it was such a precious moment. I'm like, oh, that little girl's going places.
Because of her personality, I'll be honest with you. It made me want to be a dad.
We're from a small town and we say that everybody has main character syndrome. Almost every one of our family members is a main character.
We say she came from us.
When she was little and we would have family neighborhood things, she always made the best brownies.
Mackenzie thinks that the man that is in love with her loves her for her brownies, but the truth is he likes my brownies better.
I have so many musical influences, but the classics that I was raised on, like in the car, bumping, my mom's red Suburban, it's like total Y2K country. Toby Keith, Craig Morgan, even before that, it's like Faith Hill, Shania Twain is a huge person that I like look up to and think is amazing and have listened to my whole life. Miranda Lambert, like her writing, her tone, there's just so many people that I look up to. My dad actually took me to go see Keith Urban and Carrie Underwood. That was like the big first concert that I remember seeing and I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna figure that out. I didn't have a producer, I didn't have a vision, I didn't know how to like record my music and put it out there, but I could show up every day and write a song. I just started walking into rooms and preferring the weirdest thing that we could say over the like most normal thing, because I would rather you hear something from me that you've never heard before. I just make these things up in my head and then I hope that they come out right. I do have a very wide range from the humor to the heartbreakers. Like, it covers all the bases, all the things. I want everyone to be able to listen to it and connect to something.
My daughter, Mackenzie Carpenter, kind of got a triple dog dare. She just signed her first record label deal in Nashville with Big Machine Label Group. Let's go!
I like to say that the truth is tacky, no matter what way you cut it. Everything that you do is not gonna be a perfect, beautiful visual. You're gonna see that in the songs that I sing, you're gonna see that in the pictures that are presented, in the videos. Sometimes you're having the worst day and you just gotta zip it up and move on and let yourself be tacky, whether it's the look on your face, whether it's the outfit that you have on, whether it's your attitude. I want to stand up for people telling their truth and being who they are, and not feeling like they have to show up and change or be a different way because of something that somebody says.